For those of you who don't know, I'm Maggie, and today I am so excited to share with you my favorite products and discoveries, because some of these things are just not products of 2021. And some of these things you've heard me talk about ad nauseum on this channel. And then a couple of them, you're probably gonna be like, that's weird. Never heard you talk about that all year long. And that's because these products became so commonplace that I just completely forgot to mention them because they were so ingrained in my routine, if that makes sense. And there's truly no category for any of these products, it's just all over the map. So we'll just call this lifestyle favorites. So the first product that I wanna talk about today is one of those that I've mentioned 8 million times on this channel, and it is these teeny tiny little measuring cups from OXO. So these measure a fourth of a cup in size, and we have three of them because one is constantly dirty. We use these to cook for normal things like oil or tablespoons of like tahini or mustard or, I don't know, any liquid ingredient that you're using in a small amount, we're probably using these for that. But another kind of unconventional way that we use these cups is when we're making cocktails. So rather than having a traditional jigger that is traditionally kind of hard to pour out of because it doesn't have a pour spout, we use this in place of that. So you have the ounces very easily measured, as you can see on the inside of this cup. And so since most drinks are calling for 2 ounces of liquor, it's really easy to use these and then pour them directly into your shaker. These are easily popped into the dishwasher. I will say over time, these have started to get a little bit cloudy because we do put them in the dishwasher, but I guess that's something to be expected when you're using little plastic cups all the time. But this is one of those, like, we did not know we needed it until we had them. It allows you to dirty up a lot fewer utensils when you're cooking too. We cook a lot of different pastas and soups and things like that, and oftentimes it's calling for like 1/4 cup of oil. And so this is 1/4 cup, and then I can use this exact same measuring cup for any sort of tablespoon measurements that are also in that recipe. So you don't have to get cups and tablespoons and all the different measurements dirty because you can probably figure out how to measure them all in one thing. And that's why we use these so often. So I would definitely recommend getting more than one because you're probably gonna love it just as much as we did. And we use these all the time. Next product could be cheating because I did just get this for Christmas, but it has already gotten a ton of use. We've already made 10, 12 cups of coffee at this point since Christmas Day. And this is meant to be used for the pour over coffee method. What you do is you fill this up with water. It has a little line on the inside that tells you where to fill it up. And then this sits on its own little electric stand. And you can set the exact temperature that you want the water to be. So typically for our purposes, we're setting it somewhere between 195 degrees and like 205 degrees, and it will hold it at that exact temperature for up to an hour. So maybe you wanna make a cup of coffee and then come back and make a fresh cup like 30 minutes later, your water is already hot and ready to go. But this can be used for more than just coffee. You could use this for tea. You could even use this to help your water boil faster if it takes a really long time for water to come to a boil on your stove. This is a gooseneck kettle. So that is what this little unique spout is. And this is specifically recommended for the pour over coffee method, which is what I mostly wanted to use it for. They do have a more manual version of this kettle. So this one specifically is the electric one that comes with its own base. But they also have one that goes on your stovetop, and it has a little thermometer on the top that tells you how hot the water is, which is great. And it works pretty much the exact same way, but you don't have that luxury of like doing other things while your water is coming up to temperature because you do have to kind of pay attention to that. My whole goal was to eliminate the pour over coffee method taking way too much time. And now because we have the electric kettle, it takes about the same amount of time to brew a cup of coffee in a normal coffee maker. The difference is that you're being active most of the time because you are pretty much being the coffee maker. So that leads me to the next product that we can call this a 2-in-1. You can call this 2 separate products. I don't really care. But this specific coffee dripper is just A++. So this comes specifically from a company called Blue Bottle, and this came as part of a discovery set that came with a little glass carafe that you could actually brew the coffee into and then pour into your glass. Or you can just set this dripper itself on top of your coffee cup and not have to dirty up anything else. So I like the versatility of that. This does make just 1 cup of coffee at a time, and it takes probably in total from start to finish between like weighing the coffee beans, grinding them, and actually pouring the water over, it probably takes about 5 minutes, which is, again, about the same time as it took for me to make coffee in a coffee maker. But y'all, this coffee tastes so much better. It is so much richer. it tastes like coffee shop coffee. And yes, it requires a little time and a little finesse, but it's really kind of hard to mess up, I'll be completely honest. What truly matters is if you have the right coffee measurements and water measurements, but these two things working together make an outstanding cup of coffee. So if you're somebody that is really into coffee and maybe the Keurig cups aren't doing it for you anymore, or maybe your coffee maker just kind of makes weak coffee, highly recommend this. It may be a stretch here to call these next products like kitchen related, but they do clean lots of things in the kitchen. And I had to give a shout out to Branch Basics because this is something that I learned about from The Define Dish, who is a food blogger person that I love to follow. She also lives in Dallas. And this product in particular is a powerhouse. We use this in everything. And I guess really quick before I dive into what this actually is, Branch Basics is supposed to be a lot more natural cleaning products. These don't have any bleach or ammonia, no dyes or fragrances. It has no phosphates, no phthalates, no chlorine, no SLS, no nuts or tree nuts. It's hypoallergenic. It's non-toxic. The product itself is 100% biodegradable. This is recyclable. So they're just trying to do good things with their cleaning products. And this is an all over the house kind of multitasker. So one way that we love to use this is to put this in a batch of towels, or maybe even when we wash our sheets, since we do have white bedding. And this does a really good job of removing stains, keeping your sheets from yellowing, and just really like doing a deep clean to your towels. This is also supposed to whiten and brighten, which again is why we use that with our sheets. But another way that we use this probably weekly is to take a scoop of it and put it into any sort of pan or Dutch oven that may have really caked on food. If you get that black stuff, you know, because it's been sitting on the heat and something just burned to the bottom of your pan, this will save the day without any sort of scratching, because we have like ceramic coated Dutch ovens and nonstick pans and stuff. And I wanted to show you the texture of this. Do you see how it's just kind of like a fine grain mixture? This kind of works as a safe abrasive on your pots and pans and really scrubs everything off. The first time I showed it to Brian, he was like, "What?" And he is like the primary dishwasher in our family. So he has really, really loved this. So this specifically is called the Oxygen Boost. I haven't said the name until now, sorry about that. Oh, and another use for the Oxygen Boost that we've used a lot is to like scour our shower and our bathtubs and stuff. It does a really good job of working against that soap scum and anything else that gets kind of caked or on the outside of your bathtub, or just kind of like the pink and yellowy yuckiness that forms in your shower. It's great for that. And this entire tub retails for $10. So it's super affordable. The catch is that you can only get it on the Branch Basics website. And the next product that we use a ton from them is the concentrate. That's the name of it. And this is just a multi-purpose cleaner. They say that you can use this for windows, you can use this for laundry, you can use this for floors, carpet, countertops, and we primarily use this for countertops. I have not used this for the laundry yet, but am not opposed to giving that a shot. It said that you just use 1 to 2 teaspoons per load, and then you also can use it with that Oxygen Boost. So that could be interesting. This big bottle comes with a spray bottle, and it tells you on the side to fill up this bottle with a certain amount of water and then how much soap to put on top. So you're using a teeny tiny amount of concentrate to give you an entire bottle of cleaner. And because this lasts forever, we're producing a lot less waste because we're not buying a new spray bottle every single time we go to buy more cleaning product. And this is gonna last me forever. This entire bottle of concentrate was much pricier than just the $10 Oxygen Boost. But if you wanna try these out and you don't wanna pay full price for this concentrate before you figure out how it works, I would encourage you to get their starter set. It's so inexpensive. I want to say $10 or $5. Fabulous way to try out their products, and we have been really, really pleased with how well these work. All right, moving away from the kitchen. The next thing that I bought in 2021 was my Kindle Paperwhite. Now I have mine in the color Sage, and I've owned a Kindle before. I do need to caveat this because I had the original Kindle Paperwhite that came out in like 2010. 2011, something like that. And I had that Kindle for 10 years and it finally started petering out on me this year. And so I just decided, because I use it every single day, I love to read, it was worth it to go ahead and upgrade and get the latest Kindle Paperwhite. Now this is awesome because I love to read in the bathtub, and this is actually waterproof. Don't have to worry about splashes from the bathtub water or anything like that when my bath is filling up. And then I also love that this has a backlight, which is something that my old Kindle was definitely lacking. So if I woke up in the middle of the night and couldn't sleep or something, I had to have like an old school book light. And this being backlit makes it so much easier. It makes it really easy to read on the beach because it's like anti-glare, so you can turn the brightness all the way up. Or it's really nice at night or on a dark airplane or something and you don't want to disturb your neighbor, you can turn that down and have it be a bit more dim. And then it kind of mimics the pages of a real book in the look of it. And that's why it's called Paperwhite. I really can't recommend this enough. I know I've also talked about the Libby app a ton. And if you have a local library, I would encourage you to download the Libby app and link your library card. And you can actually get free, you know, electronic library books delivered straight to your Kindle. So that's how I read 99.99% of my books is for free through my library. And I also, as you can probably see, don't have a case for this because I really just love the sage color. And I like the feel of this being light and really easy to handle without a case. So I have this sleeve to go with it. This was super cheap on Amazon. I want to say like $10 or $11. And it's done a great job of keeping everything protected with this little magnetic closure. Another major winner of 2021 is this mini clear cosmetics case. This comes from a brand called CalPak, and I have done an entire video packing this thing to really show you the outstanding capacity that it has. If you're curious about that, I'll link it in the description box below. But I love that this opens directly down the middle so that you have equal capacity on both sides. Now, this pretty much stays packed year round for me. I always keep travel toiletries in here so that that's one less thing I have to think about when it comes time to actually pack. So that is what you're seeing living on this side. And I love that you can see through it. Like I can see my little Cadence capsules here, my Q-tips, my dry shampoo, my floss. You don't have to root around for everything and you don't have to like mess up the organization of your bag because it's clear. So I love that. And then on this side, I typically keep all of my makeup and I'll usually pack that like day of. So the only thing that lives in here full time is my little mini like loose setting powder. But this has been great. It fits so well in my carry-on luggage and it obviously has a pretty small footprint, so it's not taking up a ton of space. I have TSA PreCheck and I have never, ever, ever been stopped with this. A lot of people get angry when I mention that things go through security well. I don't know why. I'm just telling you my experience with it, and this works for me every time. So take that for what you will, but if you have been in the market for a good cosmetics case that is clear, that's easy to navigate, that's high quality, highly recommend this. They make one that is about 2.5 times the size of this, and for me, that's just too big. I would prefer to travel with another travel bag to hold like my hairbrush and retainer and deodorant and things like that that can't fit in this, than to have this humongous toiletry bag that takes up like half of the side of a suitcase. Do you know what I mean? Oddly enough, I actually have two different types of hats that made the list of my favorite purchases this year. And the first one are these beanies that I wear, I don't know, every single day in the winter. These come from a brand called Herschel, and we actually got ours at Urban Outfitters. They were like 20 bucks a piece, and we have this rust color, a hunter green, and then kind of like a mustard color. And Brian and I just share all of them. These are just so cozy. There's nothing exciting about them. They're just a really basic beanie. But I like that because we're gonna be able to wear these for years and years to come. And I love that the colors are kind of muted, but they're also kind of adding a pop of color to like a traditionally drab, you know, all black winter wardrobe that I tend to always wear. They're thick, they're super warm, and they fit both my head and my husband's head easily. I also mentioned this in a travel gift guide because if you go anywhere in the winter when you're traveling, I always like to travel with a beanie, and this could easily just roll up and fit in your suitcase. It could lie flat in your suitcase and it doesn't take up a ton of room. For the amount of times that I've worn these beanies, I could not go without mentioning them because they have been very well loved in our house this year. But switching seasons for a bit, I also had to mention this hat because we went to Hawaii this summer. I went to Florida with some friends. I spent probably 2 to 3 weeks of my summer on a beach, and this was on my head every single day. It's obviously super neutral, so it matches any sort of bathing suit or cover up that you may be wearing. And I love that on the inside, it's completely adjustable. So you can see this little elastic piece right here. This can be changed with this little Velcro piece. This stayed on in wind and rain. I got this hat completely wet in the ocean when we were kind of jumping through some waves, and it would dry every day and look perfectly brand new. Cannot say enough good things about this, especially for the price. And they have different options. Maybe if this like super neutral band right here isn't speaking to you, they have like snakeskin ones, they have black ones, they have different colors. I loved this thing. And you can see this is kind of what it looks like, and it stays on super well. Another fantastic Amazon purchase were these tanks. And these are supposed to be dupes for the Lululemon Align tanks. This has a padded little shelf bra. So you can wear this like as a standalone top when you're working out, or maybe if you feel comfortable just out and about town. I have this in this light blue color and in a black. And the material is so soft. It feels so buttery and high quality. And I wanna say that I got each of these for like $20 a piece. So much cheaper than their Lululemon counterparts. They do a great job moisture wicking. They're so comfortable. And in the winter, I've actually been wearing these as just like my bra under different shirts and sweaters that I have. And it's just so comfortable. So think beyond just exercising in these, or maybe if you have like an exercise New Year's resolution around the corner, this could be something that could like, I don't know, motivate you if you feel like you need something cute to work out in. But these are just so multi-purpose, super functional. And both colors of these are seriously in the dirty clothes every single week. I cannot get enough of them. They're also flattering. They have just kind of like a little scoop neck, kind of like a V-neck, and then in the back, it has these little seams that you can kind of see. If you were in the market or eyeing those Lululemon ones, you do not need to spend that to get the quality. All right, the next item I wanted to mention is not something I purchased, it's more of a discovery in 2021. And that is the Half Baked Harvest website. Her blog is so good. This year we've really been eating a lot more vegetarian, and her website is one of those that offers a ton of really good, flavorful, filling options. Like, eating vegetarian does not have to be that boring, and I feel like so many blogs make it seem that way. But the thing that I love most are her flavors. She loves spice. She loves to season things well, and I feel like I'm never like adding salt or pepper to her meals, or like, oh, I think this needs a little something extra. No. She nails it. If you are looking for really, really good flavor, she's got you in that department. And she's not only vegetarian. I do want to throw that out there. We've cooked a lot of her meat-based meals too, and they are all outstanding. But another thing that she gets a ton of extra points for is how her recipes are actually written. You know how some recipes tell you you need 1 cup of onion and 2 tablespoons of lemon juice? And you're like, well, how many lemons do I buy, or how many onions do I buy to actually make that quantity? Well, if you are somebody that loves to follow a recipe to a T and you measure everything out like that and throw it in, great. Then those other recipes are for you. But the thing that I like about her is that when you cook, it does not have to be as scientific as baking does. And I feel like her recipes have really gotten me to be a lot more creative and a lot more flexible with my cooking with how she's written them. So it's actually taught me a lot. And there's really not a huge difference in 1 cup of onion and 1 1/4 cup of onion, or a little under a cup of an onion. So she's letting you know, like, whatever you have, throw it in there. I personally really like that because I know exactly what to buy at the grocery store, and there's a lot less waste because she's not confining you to just 1 cup of onion and then you're throwing out like 1/4 of the onion or something, if that makes sense. That's personally why I like her. She's also a great follow on Instagram because all of her pictures are beautiful. She shows you how to make her recipes really quickly, and she offers a ton of cocktail recipes, and we are huge cocktail people. Much love for Tegan Gerard. She is awesome. I love what she's doing on Half Baked Harvest. I've actually recently pre-ordered her newest cookbook that releases in February. The next thing I also can't physically hold, and that's because it's on our bed right now. It'd be way too big, way too much trouble for me to take it off. But we got this new blanket for our bed, and it has made such a difference. We loved our bed. We have a Casper mattress and we have Brooklinen bedding, but we were just missing one layer. Like, we needed it to look a little better. So honestly, this is very shallow, but I originally bought the blanket because I thought our room just needed more texture. It was totally for looks. We put it on and it adds the perfect amount of weight and coziness to our bed that we just didn't even know that we were missing. And so it comes from Target. We have a king size bed, and that size blanket was $80 if I remember correctly. Completely worth it. It's just a neutral tone. It really does add that beautiful additional layer to the bed, and it looks really nice with the added texture, but it also just feels so good to sleep under. So we have finally gotten our bed to a place where we're like, we never want to leave it. And when we do go on trips, we come back and we're like, we can't wait to sleep in our bed. If maybe your bed is missing that little something, or maybe you get too cold at night and you haven't experimented with putting some additional layers, I cannot recommend this specific blanket enough. Another big old item that I can't physically bring back here is my desk shelf. Brian got this for my birthday back in February. And I don't even know if I've mentioned this once on my channel, but this thing is great. it was one of those I did not know that I needed it items until I had it. Because Brian already had one for his desk and he was like, wow, this makes a huge difference in the amount of space that you have on your desk. Because we both use separate monitors. So one of my monitors sits on the desk shelf and then I have all of this space to store things underneath. So I have a personal computer and a work computer so I can slide one under the shelf and pull the other one out. It also came with an additional drawer so I had additional organization space. And it just gives you an extra place to put like the Kleenex boxes or even a lamp. Or anything else that you may have sitting on your desk that's just taking up valuable real estate, this shelf is amazing. Now, I do want to mention that mine specifically is from Grove Made. And while it is made with like recycled products and they're doing great things for the earth, and I think that this is a company that I definitely support and stand behind, you don't need to spend the price on a Grove Made stand. I really love what they're doing. It's a super high quality product, but they've raised the prices since we purchased ours, and I just can't justify the existing price. They have a ton on Amazon. They have some at Target. They have these all over. So just browse the internet. And the key feature that you want to look for is one that spans almost the entire length of your desk. So just having one little stand for your monitor that doesn't really offer much in the way of like an additional level of organization is not going to give you the same benefit. So when you're looking, measure across your entire desk and try to get one that's almost the exact same length, and that's where you're going to get the most value. And the last service that I wanted to mention is the Nuuly clothing rental service. This has been such a game changer when it comes to my closet. I used to be the person that would go out and just go shopping randomly on a weekend and buy things that I absolutely did not need. And then at the beginning of last year, I went through this like 30 days to minimalism kind of exercise, and it really transformed the way I think about my closet and my home and the physical things that I need. And one area where I found myself constantly decluttering was my closet. And so I was like, well, what can I do to refresh my closet for a reasonable price point that's not adding a ton of waste to this world, that's not gonna be something I'll get tired of and then donate a year later? And that was clothing rentals. I found Nuuly, and they feature brands like Anthropologie and Urban Outfitters and Free People, and those are the more like fun clothes that I wanted to wear. So when I used to shop, I would be like, oh, well, I really like that really fun dress, or I really like that really fun top, but I don't think I'm gonna get a ton of use out of them, so I'm gonna buy this boring thing. And while buying those classic pieces is good, I was never really happy with what was in my closet. So for $88 per month, you get to rent 6 items, and you can wear them as many times as you want. You don't have to do any of the laundry, and after a month, you can ship them back, or you could keep them for another month and you would just pay that fee again. The beauty in this is that I've been able to get some really fun and funky dresses to weddings and events that we've been to and not have to worry about the longevity of it in my closet. And another great thing about it is that you can purchase those items at a discount because you're a member of the clothing rental service. And the beauty of it too is that you can pause it, and you can pause it for consecutive months. You can unpause it at any time, so you don't always have to be paying that monthly fee. And you can only pay for it when you maybe have an occasion coming up or something. Just something to keep in mind. It has definitely been such a game changer in my wardrobe. It's cut down on my clothing expenses a ton. And I just feel so much better about that business model. That was a lot. Those are all of my favorite products and discoveries of 2021, and I loved filming that video. It's so fun to talk about all of your favorite things. And so if you're interested in any of them, if you want to try out some of the services that I mentioned, or maybe a half-baked harvest recipe or something, everything that I mentioned will be linked in the description box below. And if you liked this video, then like it. Stick around, subscribe, join the community, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.